Hello and welcome. You're watching Markets at Money Control. Here we wrap up the day's trading action for you. I'm Rakshita Madan. A look at the headlines first. SBI Life lists at a 5% premium. SBI cuts one-year FD rates by 25 basis points. And on a national front, terrorists attack BSF camp near Srinagar airport. Time for the markets chat now. Joining me is Uttaresh from the markets team. Hi Uttaresh.
Hi Rakshita.
The day was a range-bound session pretty much today, and start was the highest point of the day. Yeah. So what are the key takeaways for today's session?
So I think a couple of points that could be key takeaways. One is today marks the third straight session of a positive close for both Sensex and the Nifty. So I think investors could take that in their stride. We've had some pretty bad, past couple of weeks. And this particular movement or the momentum in the past three sessions, that is something that one would watch out for. The second thing, of course, like I mentioned, the close above 98.50. So there are certain support levels seen around this particular mark. And 98.50 also across actually comes across as a very positive sign. But, it's that kind of a market that, we're following a certain template of a corrective phase right now. So we really don't know what could be in store next for investors.
Right. And let's look at the specific sectors. Autos had a good run today amid all the sales numbers that are coming.
Certainly. So, yeah. See, there was a lot of positive cues globally and domestically as well what worked for the markets. One, of course, on the global front, there was, positivity seen on the global market side. On the domestic front, we had some very healthy set of auto sale trends that came in. So, for the month of September, companies have reported good numbers as far as exports and sales in India are concerned. So auto stocks across that particular sector saw some amount of rally there, barring Maruti Suzuki. That kind of a stock with that kind of a valuation, there was some amount of weakness seen there. But experts are attributing this as a cyclical downward move. And, going forward, there could be some amount of, bounce back that we could see in this particular stock. So that's one. As far as broader markets are concerned, mid-caps, they have underperformed both Sensex and the Nifty. Although they were on the positive side there, but they've managed to end lower than what Sensex and Nifty have returned today. As far as sectoral indices are concerned, barring PSU banks, PSU banks actually is largely, the weakness ahead. There's some caution actually investors are awaiting ahead of RBI's Monetary Policy Committee's outcome, which will be declared tomorrow. So any rate action that we see tomorrow, that will be, that would, probably move some rate sensitive stocks there. So I think banks saw some amount of caution there.
Right.
Additionally, we had one more sector, of course, pharmaceutical stocks. Dr. Reddy's there. That was one of the, stocks that was in focus today. There was some amount of approval seen for a product that, is used to treat high phosphorus content in that particular, as far as the human body is concerned. So intraday, we saw some amount of jump in that particular stock, but, there's some innate weakness. So as even if there is a slight rally in the stocks, the rally is actually bought into or rather sold into, which led to some amount of weak moves there,
Right. And what were the stocks that were in news today?
So, of course, like I mentioned, Dr. Reddy's was one. Additionally, we had Reliance Communications, not to forget that stock there. Over the long weekend, that is, of course, we saw some amount of news that, the merger talks between Reliance Communications and Aircel have now, they've been called off, citing some legal concerns. Experts have pointed at some valuation concerns. So, Reliance Communications today, intraday, was, it touched about 10% lower. Also, I think what led to that weakness in that stock was now there is a chance that banks could have had to, take a haircut of about 6,000 crores. This is, of course, according to a report on CNBC TV18. So this 6,000 crore figure actually has not gone down well with investors for both RCOM as well as banking stocks or the lenders to this particular company. So both sectors, bank, the lenders to RCOM and RCOM itself saw some amount of weakness there. Then, of course, not to forget the big listing that we saw today, SBI Life. Of course, a 5% listing premium, but there was some amount of cooling off. Still, it managed to end about the issue price of 700 rupees.
Right. And a check on the global markets before we go.
European markets right now, they are on the higher side. There is some semblance of political stability that investors are looking forward to, and they are cheering that. So right now, European markets, as we speak, they are actually trading on the higher side. Asian markets, on the other hand, they are looking to digest some amount of macro data, certain movements as far as the Bank of Australia is concerned. So Asia Pacific, markets there, they have actually ended on a slightly mixed note.
Right. Thanks a lot for joining
me, Uttaresh.
With that, it's a wrap on this edition of Markets at Money Control. For more news, views and updates, stay logged on to moneycontrol.com.